Good morning, neighbors. It's 6 a.m. Have you been up all night hunting for bugs? Time to take a break and relax with your favorite morning show hosts. I'm Fiona Fluffyface.
And I'm Mittens. Did you catch anything last night?
I sure did. Two cockroaches.
Sounds exciting! Did you eat them, or are you having them mounted?
I like to do something a little different with my kills. After I kill a bug, I like to scoot its crispy little body underneath the rug in the kitchen. I've got a whole collection under there right now.
Your human is going to be so pleased when she finds those.
I can't wait to see the look on her face. Mittens, why don't you tell the folks at home what brought you into the studio today?
Oh, I'm so excited to show you this. As you know, my human is a collector of cat mattresses, and the latest model just came in.
Ooh, which model is this?
My human calls it a MacBook.
I'm noticing that this mattress is completely silent. See, that would be a problem for me because I cannot go to sleep without a fan. I need the white noise to block out the world.
See, I'm the opposite. I like to sleep with one ear open at all times. Because who knows what the humans are up to? They could be opening a can or taking a chicken out of the fridge. They could be sneaking up on me to take my picture.
Ugh, I hate it when they do that. So creepy. So this mattress runs quiet. What else do you like about it?
I like to lay in my human's lap and rest my head on the trackpad. It's so smooth against my face, great for side sleepers like myself.
Ooh, that is smooth. You know what catches my eye, though, is the power cord. Mind if I give it a nibble?
Be my guest.
That is satisfying. Chewy, but tough. And speaking of chewing, let's move on to our final segment, Cooking with Mittens. What are you serving up today?
Today, I'm sharing a recipe from my cookbook called From Treetop to Stovetop. It's all about taking outdoor cuisine and adapting it for the indoor lifestyle. We start with our outdoor protein. Now, everyone has their preferences. Me, I like a nice baked lizard. First, you place it on the sidewalk in direct sunlight until the skin is nice and crispy. For time's sake, I've already baked the lizard for this segment. Now we just jump up on the counter and see what the humans have left out. Ooh, what's in the skillet? Bacon grease, score! Here's a little beauty tip. Bacon grease is an essential nutrient for keeping your coat shiny. I'll just take my lizard and drop him in the grease, roll him around a little, and voila! A tasty, protein-rich breakfast for busy mornings.
And it looks delicious. Can I try a bite?
Be my guest!
Wow, the bacon grease really adds that little something extra. I can feel my coat getting shinier as we speak.
And you can find more recipes like this one in my cookbook, From Treetop to Stovetop. Available everywhere cats buy books.
Huh, and that's our signal that my human is waking up, so we better eat fast. Give me the tail.
No, that's my favorite part. You can have the legs.
Hey, no cats on the counter. You know this. Mittens, go home. You don't even live here. Jeez. What? What is under this rug? Oh my God!
Thanks for listening to Community Cat News! And now, a word from our sponsor!
Oh, legs! Oh, God, their heads are separate! Oh, this is disgusting!
I'm Meow Meow Puffytail, attorney at law. Has your human destroyed your carefully curated cockroach collection? It took you years to cultivate that collection of cockroaches, and now it's gone in an instant. That's destruction of private property, and I can prove it in a court of law. He's your human, make him pay. 555-555-5555. Just lay on the phone. He's your human, make him pay.